In the next exercise, number 5, we will set automatic triggers to activate and deactivate traffic management strategies. So the policies in the previous exercises have a fixed start time at 8 and 10 p.m. and a duration of 50 minutes. This is adequate if the timetable of an event is known in advance, but this is not always possible. Shall we want the policies to continue until 9 p.m. regardless of the rate at which the problem is resolved? Automatic activation and deactivation of the policies in response to traffic conditions would make traffic management more efficient. To do so, we can set automatic triggers. Triggers are used to automatically activate policies in response to conditions. In this exercise, we will use a detector near the stadium exit, just in front of the conflict zone where congestion is building up. The detector is named Det Camp Nou and is located in this section. We will try to activate a policy as soon as detected occupancy is greater than 80% and keep the policy running until the occupancy statistics that we get every 5 minutes decreases to less than 20%. To do so, we need to create activation and deactivation trigger objects and add these objects to a new policy. To set the activation and deactivation triggers, we need first of all to set the detection time interval to 2 minutes. So I will open the dynamic scenario and the tab outputs to generate. Here I can modify the detection interval instead of 5 minutes to be 2 minutes. And then I will press enter. Now, to create the activation trigger, I will right click on the traffic management, new, and I will create a trigger. So a new folder with an object trigger is created. I will open the trigger and rename it as trigger activation. Then I will click a new condition. Here I can add the object and the attribute that this condition will be activated. So I will click on the detector and the attribute that I want to measure the activation of this traffic management action is the occupancy. Regards replication, which is called rep policies, and should be greater than 80%. Then I will click OK. So I have already created an object which will trigger the activation of a specific traffic management strategy. Now, to create the activation trigger, I will need to repeat the same steps, but rename the trigger as trigger deactivation. So I will create a new trigger, double click on it, name it trigger deactivation, and then I will add a new condition. This new condition refers to the same detector and the occupancy for the simulation replication policies, which should be less than 20%. The occupancy measured. Again, the occupancy is measured on this detector every 2 minutes. I get statistics every 2 minutes. So I evaluate this occupancy every 2 minutes to see if it is less than 20% to deactivate the traffic management strategy. Now I will click OK. So I have created my triggers for activation and deactivation of the traffic management strategy. To create a new policy for the triggers, I will right click on the strategy post-match and create a new policy. I will rename this policy as automatic policy. For condition, I will select trigger and start it by the trigger activation and stopped by the trigger deactivation. And then I will click OK. So far we have applied all these turn closures, destination change, force turn, and control plan change traffic management actions. These actions to be applied automatically, we need just to even inside the automatic policy. So under the automatic policy, I have all the traffic management actions to be activated by the trigger activation and deactivated by the trigger deactivation. Now we can run a new experiment using automatically triggered policies. To run a new experiment with triggers, I need to duplicate the experiment micro XMATS policies. I will click yes, and here I will rename it automatic policy. Then I will check the policies. I will deactivate the policy 1, 2, 3, and I will activate the automatic policy that contains all these policies when activated. and then I will click OK. I will rename the replication as Replication Policies Automatic and click OK. Then I will right click and run the animated simulation. While the simulation is running, I can check the following outputs to review the results of the triggered policies. Here, I can take advantage of the Viewing Microsimulation Outputs tutorial and check several statistical outputs of the network at a global or local level. I will visualize the time series of a detector. I will select the variable occupancy to see the generated map below. So I will open the detector of my interest. I will go on the variables and I will check the occupancy. I will select the automatic and see the curve. So I select the occupancy indicator to see the percentage over time of that this detector is being occupied by vehicles. So I see that at 8 p.m. until 8 and 10, this detector is not occupied at all. Once the match has ended, the fans will start leaving the stadium altogether with the arrivals distribution set to ASAP. So here I can see that the occupancy is increased by 100%. So here we see that the policy is activated at this time and the policy is deactivated at 8:50. So now let's see some time series in the Camp Nou centroid to see the outputs of the different experiments. I will double click on the centroid, check the time series tab and select the variable maximum virtual queue. Here I will add more replications. So the first of all will be the no strategy. The second one that I will compare will be the replication policies, and the third one will be the replication policies automated. And I will check the graph. The maximum virtual queue variable displays the effectiveness of its no strategy policies and automatic policies. So we can see that with the implementation of the triggers, the virtual queue is being reduced much faster than the application of the traffic management strategies with a fixed start and duration time. To view the overall vehicle density of the network for the two replications that use strategies, I can open the time series viewer. I will go on the data analysis, click Time Series Viewer, and here I will select the replication policies, select the variable of my interest, in this case will be the density, and I will add this time series. I will repeat the same process for the replication automatic. I will click on the replication automatic, then I will choose the density, I will choose another color so that I can see the difference, and I will click Add Series. To display the outputs as a bar chart, click here. So it is clear that the automated triggered policies achieve lower density by the end of the simulation, with conditions returning to normal more quickly. This is because the deactivation trigger detects when the queue has dispersed and seizes the action at the optimal time. Now let's proceed to exercise number 6, to create periodic incident. Until now, we have covered a predictable or planned traffic event, which is the evacuation of Barcelona Camp Nou. In this exercise now, we will look at how to simulate unplanned traffic events. So forget about the Camp Nou stadium and let's focus on something different. To do so, we will create a traffic condition that simulates different instances of parking within a particular road section. Due to the fact that this is not a planned traffic management action, it is best to use a traffic condition to include it in a simulation. In this way, we can create multiple incidents that are randomly located within a specific area of the network. We will simulate the network using periodic incidents in the outer lane of section 1930. To search this section ID, I will do Ctrl F, and here on the ID, I will type 1930. So this is the section of my interest. Now, to create a periodic section incident, I will first right click on the traffic management folder, new, and create a traffic condition. As I said before, traffic conditions are more for unplanned events rather than strategies that are made for planned traffic management actions. Now I will right-click on the traffic condition and select Periodic Section Incident. I will open the Periodic Section Incident, and in the two-dimension view, I will click on section 1930. So the section ID has been updated also in my dialog window. I will click on the outside lane so that it goes from lane 3 to lane 3. I will leave the visibility distance to 200 meters, the incident length to 5 meters, deviation as 0, the lanes to cover will be just 1, and the starts every 1 minute I will have a car parking on this section with a deviation of 20 seconds. And the duration will be 1 minute with a deviation of 20 seconds. You can also change the length of this traffic management action. So I can click on this black vertex to change the size and the position of this box. So the incident we have created uses the parameter 1, where a 5 meter long vehicle parks in the outside lane once per minute and for a duration of 1 minute with a variance of 20 seconds. Now I will click OK. I will head on the dynamic scenario base on the strategies and conditions tab. I will tick on the traffic condition that I have already created. I will click OK, and then I will run the simulation and observe the following result, where the outer lane is blocked at random times and the consequent effect on traffic flows. That was the end of the exercise managing traffic. Thank you for following me. See you in the next tutorial.